G'day guys, it is Trav here from Neighbourhood. Are you wanting to keep track of your team's progress towards KPIs and overall goals? Utilising the forecast tool effectively has a range of benefits, such as forecasting revenue based on the likelihood of deals to close and a whole lot more. And today we're going to show you how to integrate it into your sales, marketing and service strategies. Now as a heads up, you'll need Sales Hub, Service Hub, or enterprise to use this feature. And if you're keen on more practical support inside HubSpot, Neighbourhood offers a comprehensive, easy to follow course so that you're making the most out of your HubSpot investment. Stay tuned for more info at the end of this video, but if you wanna take your learning offline though, we'll include a free downloadable PDF in the description below. So let's get stuck in with the forecasting tool inside HubSpot. Now there's been an array of updates with the forecasting tool. Let's just hope that you're watching this now and it's the same that you can see. If not, if anything has changed, make sure you hit us up in the description below and let us know so we can update the video and keep it relevant for those that are looking to use the tool. So, have you got a sales team? Have you got a marketing team or a service team that you kind of want to keep track of just to make sure that they're hitting their targets and goals? Well, with the newly updated forecasting tool, you can do just that. Now, if you've got a sales team, then you can track on revenue. You can track on meetings or deals. If you've got a service team, you can work on, say, tickets closed. As well on the marketing team, you can work on form submissions or anything, or lifecycle stages as well, and track the progression of those. The good part about, I guess, the forecasting tool is that you can set them, agree to them with the team, and then what it will do, it will notify you when you are coming close to those goals or not gonna hit those goals. Pretty cool feature. We're always a little bit old school. We like to use this feature, but we also like to use our old school Excel spreadsheet just to make sure we're keeping across things with our complex retainers and projects. But we'll show it to you here today and we'll get stuck in. So to get into the system or to get into it, first that we're gonna need to do is we're going to need to get started on some of the goals. So we'll go to the forecasting tools. We go to sales and drop down to forecast. You'll see that here we've got one that's sort of pre-done for our sales team for our Q3 2020 goal, of which I've been a very, very bad salesperson because I have not made any sales. Don't even know why I'm still in this job, to be honest with you. But that's a bit of an example of a one-man band on a sales team. Now, if we wanted to go ahead and we wanted to create new goals, then what we would do is we would go up to the Edit Goal tab. Now, this will take you into the settings area. Inside, you can see that this is now taking us into the goals area in the settings. Now, what we've got up here is we've got, I can see that Tyler here has a goal quarterly of $20,000 for the quarter. That's a pretty achievable goal, but we'll see how we go with that. But what we wanna do here specifically is potentially set a goal for a user, or we can set a goal for a team. So we'll go through. So if we go up to the right-hand side and click on Create Goal, it'll bring into this, this is all fairly new for us, so it's pretty cool. When I opened it up, I was like, this is a whole lot easier to use. We've got the first step, which goal is it? So in this one, we might wanna say, let's just say the Q4 NBH sales targets. Nice. So we've got our category here. Now, you'll see if I click on the category, it will give us three options. And I'm sure there'll be more to come as time goes on and maybe when you're watching this video. At the moment, we've got sales, service, and marketing. So if I click on sales, you'll see the goal type that we, and it will drop down. So we can track revenue, meetings booked, deals created, and calls made. But what's to say if I work in the service side of the business and I'm answering customer requests and I'm creating tickets and making sure that those tickets get resolved in the right amount of time? We'll click on the category dropdown and we can click on service, and then we can see that the type has changed to tickets close, average time, resolution time, and response time as well. Very, very handy, especially if you've got a team of people that are servicing your clients, so that you wanna make sure, if you guys set internal SLAs to say that you wanna make sure that you get back to them within 24 hours or 2 hours or 3 hours, depending on the ticket type, you can definitely track that here, which is pretty cool. Second to that as well is marketing. If we drop it down, number of contacts, network connections, and contacts from first form submissions. So in this sort of use case, and I always sort of encourage everybody to go around and really play and set up a whole bunch of tests and goals and sort of see how they look, because you can, I'll show you in a little bit how you can actually start to do some custom reporting with that as well and then start getting notified in that as well. So in this instance, we're gonna do sales and we're gonna go across to the goal type and we wanna go revenue. Brings us to the next stage. Now, revenue can be tracked in a whole bunch of different ways, that's for sure. And this is kind of, I guess, where we do it. Here, we want to sort of go, do you intend to forecast? So create forecasts and view in reporting, or you want to create team goals with multiple pipelines and yearly milestones. In this instance, there's no real team. It's just going to be me. Let's just say that, for example, there's not a team and there's not multiple pipelines. So in this instance, I'm going to use the yes feature because I'm going to create the forecast for this goal specifically for me for Q4. And I want to make sure that I report on it. In the contributors, we've got the users. So we can drop down, select and add many users to it. Or we can go ahead and select a team specifically and then select the sales team. So in this instance, I'm just going to do myself because I haven't performed very well at all last quarter. The year is 2022. If it might be 2024 by the time you watch this video, who knows? But it's 2022 now, so we're going to set the year for 2022, but we can go ahead and go forward and plan for 2023 if you need. There is a little caveat down there if you want to change. We're currently in fiscal, but if you need to change that, you can do that in the settings and it'll just pop up and you can change that yourself there. I know some European companies definitely work from a January to December. Us in Australia, we kind of work from July back to June. So then we've got the pipeline. So you might have several pipelines. We've got a bunch of pipelines that we've been playing and showing examples with clients with. In this instance, we just want to go NBH sales pipeline and click on that one. Now it's saying here the pipeline is set to a monthly duration. If you need to change the settings on that, you can just do so there. I do encourage you to go ahead and click into these and just check to see what these settings are specifically. This is a bit of a speed round for you, if you will, but go through and have a bit of a play. It's definitely encouraged. Don't do it on live pipelines though. So we're gonna click on next and it brings up a really easy to use, visualization on what the targets are specifically for 2022. So we might go across and we're in September now. So let's just do the last 3 months here. So we might say that, the month for that might be 450,000. Then we might want to do 350,000 and it might teetle off a little bit at 250,000 in December. So we can see that just if I'm forecasting, I guess, for October, November to December, you can see here that I've got 3 out of the 12 months and 100% of the total is 1,050,000 that we've got there. You could potentially retroactively put in, what the targets were if you do have them, and it might actually apply to the actual how the performance has been for that person. Realistically, you don't really want to track what's happened before. I think tracking what's happening ahead is probably a little bit more something that you want to sort of do. After that, I can see that these targets here have been set and I want to click on next. So this is where the notifications sort of come. And because I'm the contributor of it, I'm going to get notified because it's helping me get a really broad understanding about how I'm performing as per the pipeline here. So I can see here that the goal kickoff. So I'll get a notification once I click on done. That'll tell me what my goals are. Great if you've got teams. So for example, you might have three teams and three people in each of the teams. You might be setting specific goals for each of those teams. They'll all get individual emails as per to what those targets are. If you go back to the other screen where you saw me, you'll see the teams there and you can add the team targets there and everybody will be responsible for hitting those forecast targets in those teams. In there, exceeded the goal. So if it exceeds 100, I'll get a notification. If I've achieved it, it'll also go ahead and give me a thumbs up. And when I didn't reach the goal, it will tell me as well. Personally, I would like to get a notification on how I'm going 50% into the time and also 75%. That would help me get a good idea. A good salesperson should know exactly where they are specifically in the month to how they're tracking. But again, HubSpot's rolling out changes all the time. So if that is definitely something that you want to do, I urge you to go to the community, HubSpot community page and find it and put up something because I'm sure there's about 1,000 people out there that are asking the same thing. And the more upvotes you can get, the more it can get put in there and created for you straight away. So we'll go through, we've got the notifications. We're gonna go through and click on done. So we've come back to the forecast page and what we can see here now is that we've got the Q4 22 title that we had in there, which is really, really good. We've got me as my own sales team man. We've got our targets, so 1 million and 50,000 as discussed. And so what we've done in here is we've set in the settings for the pipeline, these are the stages that we've got specifically in here as well. So what this is gonna start to look at is how much of the deals are in each of the pipelines. And then at the end, we'll have as well the contract sent and also what's won. So we can then get a really good idea about how we're tracking using this form. Now, you can in the settings go through and set what page that you land on when you first log into HubSpot. This will give you a really good indication. Also really good for like managers and business owners of that matter to see how they're progressing as well. One thing I did stumble across that I don't know if it's like fairly brand new, but was the forecast submissions as well. So say for example, I'm reporting to the team every fortnight on how things are tracking and how things are going. I'm able to forecast the submission on what that's going to be based on what I'm projecting, and that's going to be from me myself. So if you look to the right here and we click on the little pen, what we can do is we can sit here and say, well, this is the forecast submission for myself for the period end. I'm just going to go to October. And then I will sit there and go, cool, I've sat down, and I predict maybe every week or every fortnight this might be better for you guys to do, but we'll sit there and say, I know that it was 350,000, I think it was back then for October, and say, look, I'm probably only gonna hit 300,000, and I'm gonna sit there because I lost a deal and I had COVID. There you go, that's probably a good one. Probably a little bit more believable, that's for sure. And then we'll go ahead and submit the forecast. And then what we'll do, that will go ahead and stick on that sort of file so that when you're sitting down with the manager a bit later on, it's all there, but you're keeping across on file exactly what's going to be hit when for that sort of certain period. Now it's all going to change a little bit differently for each of the ones. So this one is sales specific. There's obviously marketing, so leads, or we've got life cycle stages that they've got. You've also got ticketing. So it's a really sort of speed round on how to sort of go ahead and create those goals and then put it into the forecasting tool. But if you are wanting to use it for the servicing team or the marketing team, go through, you can create those goals specifically, and then you can go through and use the tool there for the forecasting. And there you have it. Now you know how to use a forecasting tool inside HubSpot. Now, if you're wanting to make the most out of your HubSpot investment, HubSpot does offer a step-by-step course covering marketing, sales, service, and CMS Hub in depth, ensuring you and your team are best serving your customers while developing efficient internal processes. Now we'll include a link for this in the description below. As well, if you're after a PDF version of this for later, or you're passing it into a mate in need, we'll include a link in the description as well. Now if you've gained value from this video, or you're keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Well, that's it from me. Happy HubSpotting.